Hello, number eights. You are tuned into Ruhani Guidance, and this is your rest of the month prediction for the month of September. If your date of birth are on 8th, 17th, or the 26th of any month, this is a general reading. Please take whatever resonates and leave the rest. And for personalized readings, you can reach to me. My email is mentioned in the description box below. Also, before I start with your readings, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Like, comment, share, and help the Ruhani family grow. So your energies come up as Five of Swords and the Lovers. You always have an option in a conflict. You either participate or you don't. Number eights, this week will be, for the rest of the month, it will be in your best interest to not participate in any fallouts, any disagreements, any arguments, because you need to save your energy. You need to save your energy for bigger things. You have a lot going on in your life, on your romantic front and your work front, and you might feel extremely exhausted. You might feel as if it's just everything from everywhere coming towards you. But here, what I would really like to say is that if you again in your love life, if you are really attached to the person, if you have this soul connection, it is not important for you to participate in every disagreement. You just say that you don't agree with it and you move on. If you're wrong, you just say sorry and move on. You do not, even if you're wrong, you just accept your mistake. You learn to have failure and then you move on. That's it. This week, your theme is to move on. The rest of the days of September, you just have to learn to move on. On the love front, I have the Tower and the Creator. Tower moment coming for my number eight. So let's see what the Tower moment here means. What is the Tower moment for number eights in their love life? Again, I see this is out of a lot of heat and communication, wrong words of communication. I see a lot of heat, aggressiveness in you throughout the month. I mean, that's your influences. Five of Wands, competition, Page of Wands, Ten of Swords. Under the deck, we have Seven of Swords. So this could also mean that a lot of arguments, like I said, a lot of arguments, a lot of conflict, bad usage of words could lead to this aggressive tone, aggressive communication, to and fro of aggressive communication could leave you very, very disappointed, could leave you very hurt. But you are the creator, you create what you speak, and if you speak the right words, you will have the power to manifest bigger things in life. If you use the right words, it's going to lead you to right directions. If you use the wrong words, it's going to, of course, lead into a separation. This is a possibility that only you and you can control. This is a condition where you will have to keep your mouth locked, and that's the only way to prevent this Tower moment. Otherwise, with the sort of energies that we have, you could very well have a Tower moment in your love life. On the work front, Ten of Wands and the Source. You are definitely ending a very big cycle. These temporary extra responsibilities are going to go. Do not take pressure and just help, just help yourself by delegating a lot of tasks. Things will not remain as stagnant as they are. You don't have to take so much responsibility, and there are new things coming up for you. There are absolutely new things coming up for you, number eights, and you will see in the coming days. you will see in the coming days that you know, you will be presented with new opportunities. If you have to take a class or a course to updo your or upgrade your skills, please do that, because that will really help you get newer skills under your belt. Looking at some of the advices that we have for you, trust. If there is a question, if there is a topic, if there is a person on your mind and you don't know what to do about a situation, the answer is trust. Another advice from the sacred traveler, mystic healer, healing energy flows through you. Heal. Number eights are just usual healers themselves. Inborn talent, number eights have, that is of being able to heal a lot of people and a lot of things around them. Use that. Again, 26, we are connected energetically. Definitely dealing with an 8 or a number 4, a number 2. Even number 4 had some cards that that connected with number 8. Strange. So, could be dealing with number 2 or number 4. But you are energetically connected. Everything is falling apart. This is what your partner can feel. This is a message from your partner. I'm sorry, I think I forgot to mention. This is what they want to tell you. We are energetically connected. They feel whatever you feel. So I think you need to feel good things so that the vibes pass on to them. And things start settling down for you in your love front. So number 8, all in all, if I see, if you can control your aggressiveness, if you can control your speed and your speech, a lot of things will settle and will be subtle by themselves, and things will improve just by themselves. Again, number 8s, you are also looking. We are also looking at some changes that are happening in the celestial environment. A lot of planets are changing positions. A lot of planets are moving signs. Some are turning direct. Some are turning retrograde. Retrograde, no, but direct, yes. Retrograde planets will be having next month. But, you know, a lot of these things will have an impact on us. Just make sane decisions and you should be okay. Okay, do not make haste makes waste, and do not take any decisions in haste. So number 8, this is your rest of the month prediction as per your date of birth. If this resonates with you, please write to me in the comment section below, and I would be really, really happy to read your comments and your feedback. And if you like the content that I share, please like, share, comment, subscribe, and help the Ruhani family grow. Until I bring the next reading, stay home, stay safe, and stay tuned to Ruhani Guidance.